Hello and welcome back to the channel, everyone. I am the Wiz, or the Delivery Wiz. It is Wednesday evening. You see, I have positioned my camera in a different position just for video quality testing. I had to close my sunroof. The sun behind me is setting in the west over California, and it's a little bright. It's starting to get to my back window, so we're going to make this fast intro. If you're new to the channel, welcome. If you're returning, thank you for coming back. Hope you enjoyed today's video. We are going to multi-app. There's some different news though. I got accepted. I was on the wait list for Shipt and I got accepted and they did the background check and everything. Now I'm on there, but most of the orders I've seen this afternoon were Henderson, which is a 30-minute drive to Henderson, and I'm not going to drive down there and try to work that area. It's too far away from home, and I would advise this for everyone at home as well. Don't drive so far for work unless you know you're going to be productive down there and make a shift of it or a day of it, whichever you like. With that, we're just waiting here for a decent order to pop up. I'm going to turn on DoorDash now. I did not turn that on yet, and we'll see what happens. Hopefully. The other thing too is I apologize, I just watched some of my videos back. It's not filling the whole screen of the YouTube box, and that must be my fault in post-production. I'm going to fix that up because it doesn't look that good. And the lighting, I am going to try some different things because the lighting without a light was pretty abysmal, and I apologize for that. It was a test video, so you know, bear with me as I get used to this. I am still noob or a newbie or all of the above. Another thing is if anybody else has a phone connect to their car automatically via Bluetooth, if there's some way to get audible notifications when it's connected instead of silent notifications, please comment below and help me out because I can't figure that out and I'm a tech guy. And it's starting to upset me because I don't want to have to disconnect it all the time. So any solutions, any suggestions, please let me know. All right, let's... And then here is Skipcart. Everything's down in Henderson. And here we go. They're just recycling and recycling, adding a dollar or so. The one thing I don't like about Spark, and I wish they would take care of this, once I reject it, I don't want to see it again. Maybe if you add $10 to it, I'd like to see it again. But other than that, please, once I click reject, don't bring it back to my phone. Or do something like InstaCart does now. You can hide the batch, and if they add to it, then it shows back up with the little fire sign so you know it's a repeat with the little increase on it. Please, Walmart, try to do something. I understand you got to get these orders out and people to pick them up, but... I don't want to see it coming over and over again. It's a little bit too much. So I guess we're going to have to turn on DoorDash since nothing else is popping up. I also wanted to let everyone know that I have been trying to do Frayt or Dispatch, and it is just bad. I mean, $22.50 for 18 miles, and I'm telling you, if you look here, I'll put the screenshots up. Trust me. You'll see that I have to drive 25 minutes there, pick it up, and then, you know, some ridiculous to Henderson, to the east side of town, and then I have nothing after that. If they gave me a batch with like 5 stops on it and it paid X amount of dollars, I would jump all over it. But one stop, and I may not even be over there, so I have to drive over there, take it, drive to the other side of God's earth, then home, for $22.50, I'm sorry, Frayt. I'm sorry, Dispatch. It's not going to happen, and they're not very good offers. And you're going to say, well, Wiz, they have to make money. Yes, they are doing just fine, trust me. They can afford maybe $40, and then I'm all over it. But, you know, just one man's opinion in this economy doesn't mean I'm right, doesn't mean I'm wrong. You make your own decisions on how you want to work. An interesting thing from Shipt, I took a screenshot and I didn't read it close enough. Now I just reread it. It says that you have to wait for the card to come. In the meantime, just take prepaid or delivery only orders. And that's pretty cool. So I'm glad I took a screenshot of that because I might have boo-booed and tried to take something and paid for it. And they would have told me, hey, you know, go piss up a rope, buddy. You don't have the card, go away. 6 o'clock on a Wednesday, and the Centennial Hill Zone is gray. So slow or oversaturation of drivers? I don't know. Kind of weird. Albertsons, 10 items, 850, 6/10 of a mile. The guy lives on top of the grocery store and can't go a half a mile. 10 items. I don't know what the items are. That's the problem. Well, we haven't accepted anything to this point, so let's just go ahead and take it. It takes us 2 seconds to get to Albertsons, and it's... So we're going to Albertsons, 10 items. Let's just take a look and see what they got. Wild-caught shrimp meat. Garbanzo beans. Broccoli florets. Mangoes. Eggs. Pumpkin. Whole cashews. All right, let's go try to shop for this nonsense. This is going to take more than I really want to put into it. But we took it. Let's go do it. You'll see exactly how long it takes to get to Albertsons from exactly where I was sitting at. I am not going to stop the camera or edit this part out at all. And you see, we turn around the corner, and it's right in front of us. I just gotta find a place to park, pretty much. It's a tough shopping order. Shrimp, cashews, pumpkin. Hopefully, it doesn't take more than 15 minutes. Otherwise, we'll have egg on our face. All right, we have arrived. Just gonna let this gentleman and another couple walk across with their baskets. We can't forget our red card. Oh, we'll let this lady walk across. All right, we're here. We're gonna go inside and do this Albertsons. All right, we're done shopping. It took 11 minutes. It took longer to check out than it did to shop. It's, I hate to admit this, but I know the store a little bit better than I would like to admit. I did have difficulty finding a bag of frozen shrimp, even though I looked right at it a few times. But now it is 2 minutes to the delivery, 6/10 of a mile. So I'm just gonna leave the camera run and you can come along. Getting offers from Spark to drive down south to Charleston and Jones. I'm not gonna do it. Let me just reject that. It's not paying enough. So, not, by all means, just because I reject offers for 6 miles for $9 doesn't mean that you have to. If you wanna do it, then please go ahead. Just try to maximize your dollar per hour and keep that in mind. And try to do between $1.50 and $2 a mile. It's the best rule of thumb out there. And yes, the sun is blazing right in my face. I can't see the phone. Not that I really need it. But hey, it's always nice to have an idea which way you're going. There's another offer from Spark I'm not going to look at. I did take a $9 four-item order from Smith's right after this. So as soon as we do this, it's about a mile to the Smith's. And so I got us a job to follow up with. And here we are turning into their apartment complex or condo complex already. And hopefully The gate's open. So we're just gonna zoom into the gate. Not sure if this is the right way or not, but we're in the gate. Building 5. So they were polite enough. They were polite enough to leave us a gate code and a building number. So you gotta applaud these customers. Although building 5 is probably on the other side of the complex. But I turned in left because it was open. It's okay. We'll just drive around the whole complex. Again, out here in this market, you definitely go into a lot of gated communities. Do yourself a favor, stop at the gate before putting the code in and look at a map to give yourself a better idea where the building is so you don't drive all over the place looking for it like I am right now. So learn from my mistakes, please. There's building 8. I think I saw building 4 there. Hopefully 5 is gonna be right around the corner here. Building 15. Where did we go wrong? We went wrong somewhere. So Smith is right here next to us. Right on the other side of this fence I'm driving past is how close they live to this grocery store. All right, we're gonna go this way. Oh, there's building 4. I was mistaken. I guess I didn't read the number right. Oh, building 5. There we are. We just finished the DoorDash 10 item shop and deliver. 10 easy items to find. I actually know the store a little bit better than I'd like to admit, which I already said, and I said it's twice now. I missed a $36 Walmart shop and deliver order for 41 items for like 6 miles. I was reading it. I was trying to make sure there was no water and stuff and how far east it was going. I wish I would have grabbed it. It was a good offer. Walmart's super easy to shop at. We missed it. We're off to Smith's and we've got 4 items from there, 4 miles, $10 basically. And we're off to Smith's and we're gonna do a 4-item, 4-mile delivery. We have a super simple order, some Gerber and some vegetables. This is pretty nice. One of the nicer ones. You get a kosher area. Lots of bunkers for specialty items. They're always remodeling it, as you can tell. So we got a bag of onions, 4 honeycrisp apples, and 6 bananas.
Is that Mark Dale?
Yeah. Claudio's Dale.
Apples. Six bananas. 4:46 shopping time. It's all good. There's two of them. I'll take one, you take the other. Okay, well, there's that too. There's one right here too. You guys are good. Thank you, though.
Processing. Swipe or insert card and follow the
take a photo of the receipt. We'll be on our way. Jumping up and down the take here at the moment. Just so many store numbers to try to memorize. All right, we finished the Smiths, four items, six bananas, bag of onions, four apples, and some chewable snacks for a baby. Very fast. I brought you with the chesty. It's about time I get used to wearing this all the time and bringing you with. There's no sense in not. Sometimes the adventure is inside the store. Anything can happen. So now we're just going to go deliver this, and we'll see what the totals are at the end. Okay, we have not delivered this yet, but on the way over, we got a Spark order that is right here to the right, and I'm going left a little bit. So I'll put the screenshot up here, and you'll see it's 10 something or 9 something for 5 miles going north. I want to work that way the rest of the night. So it's no tip, but it's 6 items at Walmart. It's gonna take like 5 minutes and then 5 minutes to deliver. So that's why I took it. Yeah, we're almost here. So as soon as we drop this off, I'll give the totals and we'll head over to Walmart.